Hi everybody, welcome again to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. I can't do it. No, honestly, I can't cut no record. Alright, so today, and the reason why it's looking like this, all of it was like this, but the reason why it's looking like this, I took some out of this to place over there because I'm trying to actually get here to look like here. Alright, so forget to introduce the topic. Alright, today's topic of the shear, right, is the benefit of using giant duckweed in your outdoor pond. Now I just have a little surface agitation with a little pump, a 120 pump, which actually serve as an agitator. I'm kind of giving a little oxygen there, but most of the oxygen that exists is in this pond for my Jack Dempsey comes from my giant duckweed plant, right? It actually produces oxygen, which actually helps to sustain life within the pond. All right, so the benefit, and the benefit of using this plant. One, all right, look at that water. Water look black, right? Okay, all right, I am going into the pond now, and tell me if the water still look black. Okay, now we are in the pond. This is my Jack Dempsey. Probably might not even see any Jack Dempsey because I'm using my GoPro. As I can see, I can't see anything that is in the pond until dark, right? Look, my hand is still in the water. You can still see the pink part of my hand, right? Right, good. All right, this is clear water, guys. Clear water. This water would not have been so clear if I never have my giant duckweed. Right, it's the pond is situated in one of the sections of my yard where the sun actually pelts on it. What I do sometimes is to actually have the cut section of the tote over it at one point in time, so as you know, to limit the amount of sunshine that actually hits it. Probably not even get it properly. All right, let's look at my tilapia pond. This is my tilapia pond. The reason why you know that fish is in there is because the tilapia really and truly is orange, so you actually see them moving, right? But as you can see water look, you can actually see my hand to a point, but as my hand go further down, you realize that my hand is lost into the green water, right? The water is really green, and most of the greenness at the top have actually dissipated because my pleco is there doing their work. In which they are actually consuming some amount of algae, right? Okay, so my Jack Dempsey pond is not looking like it. It's much clearer. You can actually see the fish. I know that Jack Dempsey have this. My Jack Dempsey pond is not looking like it. It's much clearer. You can actually see the fish. I know that Jack Dempsey have this earthish tone, right? And you can actually see my Jack Dempsey in the pond swimming at this time. Right, unlike this pond, and this pond is underneath some aki tree and guinea tree and cherry tree, so it gets more shade than the Jack Dempsey pond, right, which is more into the sun. Now I am trying to get a carpet of, what should I say, a layer of giant duckweed covering the entire area here. I'm gonna give you updates as I go along. I've taken out some from my Jack Dempsey pond, and as you can see, it's coming good. It's coming good, right? What I'm gonna have to do now, I'm gonna have to make a little feeding ring right here to control the beat of the water as it comes down from the filter, and probably make two more feeding ring in the pond so as to allow the fish to actually consume. Because when these fish are being fed, I mean, the feed is thrown all over the place, right? Okay, so get your drama now, how should I say. All right, I'm trying to speak standard language now. Beneath this pond, how should I say, in this pond at the right, you see a lot of plant litter. This plant litter is coming from my aki tree and my cherry tree. Now if my giant duckweed like this pond, my Jack Dempsey pond, if it was thick like this, if the plant was like fully covering the pond, whenever a leaf actually fall in my pond, what normally happens is that it normally stays at the top of the plant. Until I come, I will just take it up and I throw it out. Now, with my convict cichlid, this is not so, because it doesn't have that buoyancy, because there's not much plant there, right? So in a sense, it helps, it limits the amount of plant litter that actually falls into my pond. So it actually catch the leaf them and all those little brambles that might fall into the water as a result of breeze blowing, right? It shade my pond from the sun, right? Also, whenever there are flies, the flies tend to stay up at the top, swim at the top of the pond, among the roots of the giant duckweed, so as to stay out of the larger fish mouth. Right, so as far as that is concerned, I think that those are two plus. But one of the biggest plus, because remember, you know, this is a plant, and plant needs nitrites so as to grow. So I have X amount of I have X amount of Jack Dempsey in this pond, and so as to survive, the plants actually do an exchange. So the plant actually, unlike this one that only have frequent water change, yeah, these are my tilapia, frequent water change and air filtration, right? This one has infrequent water change, water hardly changing this, like probably once a month, if so much, right? Probably once a 2 months, right? The plant roots actually consumes the waste from the fish, right? And in exchange of that purification process, the plant actually give, so the fish give the plant the waste and the plant give the fish the oxygen. So both of them work together, and they are happy and they are doing well, right? This is just a little agitation. I'm going to be placing a filter pond like that here. But right now I'm working on my projects with regards to my aquarium summer series, right? The aquarium built and decoration and installation for the summer, right? So I am like backward on that. But as far as my giant duckweeds are concerned, they grow, and they grow really, really rapidly when they're ready. They have actually covered my pond. They have allowed me to actually shift away a little of my shift away a little, and I can actually see the cinder blocks that exist in my pond, and I can see a few of the fish swimming now. As I said before, the fish, the Jack Dempsey, has an earth-like color tone, so it's not that easy seeing it from this angle. However, with my GoPro, it's a little bit more different. It's hope that this video opens your eyes as to some of the benefits that giant duckweed can have for your pond. Some persons are gonna probably say that it's really a nuisance to them. They want to see their fish, but who tell them that their fish want to see them? That was just a joke. All right, thank you very much for tuning in. Catch you next time for a little rest, and then see what happens later when I get up to edit this video. Bye bye for now. Peace out. Catch you next time, Valley. Oh!